Improving access to COVID-19 testing remains at the top of the list for policymakers and healthcare professionals. One strategy to increase testing capacity has been a push for rapid point-of-care testing. Rapid results and the ability to test patients anywhere could give more people access to the testing they need. Right now, the FDA has authorized 4 molecular tests and 3 antigen tests for use at the point of care. As companies develop new tests and ramp up production, it's likely that more physician offices and other sites will consider using them. As with any other patient testing, following regulatory and quality standards is essential, both for legal reasons and for patient safety. Most physician offices that perform testing operate what the FDA and the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services call a WAVE laboratory. They're called WAVE because they're exempt from nearly all the federal regulations that an advanced hospital lab has to follow. The trade-off is that a WAVE lab can only perform tests that the FDA has determined to be low risk. For primary care physicians, a WAVE point-of-care test can make a meaningful difference in convenience and care for patients. However, especially when it comes to infectious diseases, physicians will need to proceed with caution to avoid regulatory and quality pitfalls. And some state governments add their own rules. So, how can a physician office get trusted results? By definition, it's supposed to be easy to get the right answer using a WAVE test. Under CLIA, the only requirement is to follow the test instructions. But just like it's easy to get a correct answer, it can also be easy to get a wrong one. Why? Many test systems have internal checks. Some you can see and others you can't. For example, some simple tests show a control line, like a home pregnancy test, that tells you if the system itself is working. Instruments that are more complex will have special electronic controls that can flag problems. However, these internal checks really only tell you if the instrument is working. They can't flag a multitude of human errors that happen before or after the instrument does its job. To deal with human error in sample handling, instrument operation, and result interpretation, the CDC has set out recommendations to help. CDC developed these recommendations after finding in studies that more than one-third of WAVE labs didn't have or were not following the instructions for their tests. One of the CDC's top recommendations is to develop a written procedure manual that goes above and beyond the test package insert itself. The procedure manual helps ensure a safe and reliable workflow. For example, it documents required supplies, key steps in the testing procedure, quality control practices, how to record and report results, patient identification, pre-test information for both the testing personnel and the patient, and other important elements of the total testing process. The CDC also emphasizes what are called external quality controls. External controls mimic patient specimens and help monitor the testing process. Regular use of external controls is an area that those who work outside of clinical laboratories often forget. The good news is that with proper procedures, many WAVE tests can provide reliable results. For physicians who may consider bringing testing for COVID-19 or other infectious diseases in-house, it's well worth the trouble to do the homework on proper procedures and to train their staff. This preparation goes a long way to ensuring quality test results that avoid errors and improve patient outcomes.